Bleach episode 19, I am extremely, extremely excited for this episode, and I really just can't wait to talk about it in general. It is going to be a Rukia episode, so all the Rukia fans are going to love this automatically off the bat. I mean, Rukia in any episode is just great. I mean, even the mask fight with Renji, people are talking about Rukia, so I already know the fangirls, the fanboys are going to love this episode, and yeah, let's just jump into this because I can't wait to just fanboy. So as always, hit that like, subscribe, all that waffle, and let's just get into it. So before we get into the images and what my overall thoughts are on this is going to be, let's talk about the description of this episode. And again, sorry for the poor translation, but it is what it is. You know how we roll with this. Ichigo, having completed his training at the Soul King's Palace, hears that the Quincy invasion has already begun and immediately takes off, descending towards Serate, where he communicates with Urahara and tells him that he will take care of it. Meanwhile, Harshwolf takes Uryu to the execution site in Silburn, where he mercilessly executes the defeated Kangdu and BG9, then begins to talk about his liege, Yuha Ba. Furthermore, Rukia confronts Asuna and wields the Sode no Shirayuki fiercely in the face of fear. I did that all in one take, and I'm very proud of myself. Righto, first and foremost, people who were asking about Kangdu and BG9, finally you are going to get your scene. I know people were mentioning it from last episode that it wasn't there, and people are just confused of what's going on, so finally we're going to get to see what's going to happen with them in this episode. The question is, who is going to be doing the execution of Kangdu and BG9? Is it going to be Uryu or Harshwold? I still think it's going to follow the manga in regards to Harshwold, but I would like to see how Uryu brought them in, so to say. So hopefully there's a little bit of extra scene in regards to that, but it does seem that we're finally going to get the end of those two and our last chance to really know what BG9's script actually is. But I think we will all go with the headcanon until a data book comes out that it is going to be the knowledge. That being said, Ichigo completing his training, going to the Soul Palace. One, I love this screenshot that you'll see of Ichigo in this video, because in the PV, we don't really get to see any of the patterns within the clothing. I know a few people, especially a friend of mine within my Discord server, go join it, description, that link in the description down below, is that he really wanted the patterns that Senjimaru has, and thankfully we do get that. A lot of things in the PV do seem to look correct, so which is really cool. I'm glad that it's not all just plain colors and has some textures to them, so I'm glad we get to see that. Now, regardless of whether this is going to be at the end of the episode or at the start, that's another question for itself, but I do think it's probably going to be one of those end credit scenes. So yes, Ichigo comes down, but he says he talks to Urahara, but again, that can still be at the end credit, so who knows. I don't know what I'm waffling about in regards to that. So this episode is seeming to be Rukia versus Asnote. And obviously, if you have read the manga, you know what's going to happen in this episode. There's going to be some massive revelations. You're going to get to see Rukia fight in a way she's never really fought before. And it's going to be new and exciting for all of us manga readers and even anime original watchers. And I have to say, like, I love this already, this team working on it. Of course, Taguchi having the storyboard on this one. So you know it's going to be great storyboard-wise. But also, my girl Cindy is back. I love Cindy because, of course, she comes back on a Rukia episode. But Cindy is an amazing animator. And one thing that I've missed from this core is the use of her shadowing. I love her style in general. And you can always tell when it's like a Cindy shot. So I'm excited to see her artwork back in this core. And hopefully we get to see her in more of core 3 and 4. So Cindy, if you're watching, please come back. The community needs you because your work is always fantastic. But that being said, we get to see a picture of Asuna, we get to see some images of Rukia. The image of Rukia is slightly different considering it is the same panel to which I think is being adapted in this image, but it also shows that there is like this ice or frost that is covering Rukia, whereas in the manga it really didn't. So I do very much like the attention to detail on that, but it does seem that this is going to be, again, I'm going off assumption here, that this is going to be one of those priority episodes. Now, I have not seen this episode, so I'm going to assume, considering that Taguchi is on the storyboard, that this is going to have some level of priority and some level of high animation, which, you know, I'm not expecting on the Bankai. No one should expect high animation on the Bankai. We're going to have to assume, you know, the Bankai itself is going to have some amazing effects. I expect some great background, great background effects and animation in regards to the background, rather than the characters itself, because obviously if you know Rukia's Bankai, you know it. And, you know, even though it's called a spoilers video, you'll see if you're an anime only watcher what the context of a bankai is. So I expect there to kind of take more consideration around the background art more so than the character itself. However, Rukia, before she goes in that form, has great opportunity here to use a lot of techniques, has a lot of movement, and a lot of ability she has under her belt. Very excited to see what they're going to do with Rukia. And Asuna is a great character as well. And I guess the question is, and I feel like I kind of don't want CG in this sense. There's a part in the episode, or should be in the episode, where Asuna does transform to a certain degree. I'm hoping that this particular one isn't CG, because I feel that it being drawn would look better in this regard. Like, I've talked about CG with, you know, Komamura's Bankai and CG with Rose's Bankai, and I felt that they looked fine for what they were, but I feel like this needs to have the creepy effect, and I feel we can only really get that with drawn animation for Asuna. I'm not going to be opposed to it if it's CG, if it looks right, but I'm going off my own, like, vision of what I'm painting a picture in my head, so I'm hoping that it is drawn, Asuna's thing, and of course, I'm very excited to see Byakuya come back, and that's going to look great too. So I feel like there's a lot of opportunity here for some really great motion, really great animation, really great character acting, really great directing, and really great opportunity for style here. And yeah, there's nothing really more to say to that. I expect this to be how it's going to go. Especially from the manga. I do think it might be a little bit fast paced, but I mean, we have Kenpachi versus Gremmy after this episode, which there's a lot to talk about in regards to that, especially with people worrying. But I think after seeing this episode, I think people hopefully will have a little bit more faith with the Kenpachi fight, because this is, if there's anything that I'm confident about, obviously being Kenpachi versus Gremmy is a priority episode, I do feel like this is a priority episode. Like, it's too big of a moment for there not to be a priority here. And again, considering the staff, I believe we also have like a Disney animator on this too. I don't really like to tend to look at the staff too much, because I tend to not know much about staff, or I'm not very familiar with their works. I usually just do a quick Google search or see what people's impressions are on Twitter. So I tend not to speak about them too much in fear that I cause any misinformation. But from the quick glance that I did have a look at the staff, it does look like a pretty strong roster here. So I'm very excited to see where this is going to go and experience some new animators for the first time as well, as well as bring back some current ones. So I'm very excited. So with that being said, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of this roster, what you think of this episode, what are you expecting, what do you want? Do you think there should be CG for Asuna? Do you think it should be drawn? Don't be biased. You know, what do you think is going to make it pop out or have an impact the most? And yeah, anything pretty much in between all of what I've just said. With that being said though, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been a handsome one. And as always, people, peace out.